You know where I would like to go? I'd like to go to that fucking El Dorado city.
The mythical one that
Oh, yeah.
The mythical one they haven't proved to not exist yet. Come on now.
So, Woody, where would you like to go in time?
Hey, Kyle, let me say, they found Troy. Why can't they find something else?
You know, I've seen the past. Why not future, right? Why not, I don't know.
I've lost an arm!
Good.
Spoilers for Dune here, if you haven't read book fucking three, but, you know, the spice turns people into worms. All of them, you know, like Paul Atreides turns into a goddamn worm man later on. I hope Zendaya, like, sucks his worm dick. I want to see that.
How do they get so big?
Oh, I don't know if they turn into the gigantic worms. He turns into like this man-sized worm who's more man.
Worst of both worlds. So you don't even get the power of the giant worm.
I think I could hit him before he reloads and gets
me. It's like that that scene from The Patriot where Mel Gibson does that. He like gets them to fire. They all shoot their fucking guns and then he goes, ha ha! He's got a hatchet, a tomahawk in one hand and a blade in the other, and he just starts running.
Now, in fairness, that could have been avoided for those redcoats with just the smallest amount of planning. Which is like, oh, I remember, brothers. Don't all shoot at the same time, like, yeah?
Remember, because first thing they do is they kill all the officers right away. And then, like, the remaining sergeant is like, he orders, like, volley fire at that, at like, the tree. He's like, everyone fire! And now everybody's empty. And then you just need Mel to, like, distract the one guy who didn't shoot. And then it's just fisticuffs. That's a great scene. I need to watch that movie again.
You would know this, Kyle. You know celebrities. Has anyone else notable ever masturbated themselves to death like David Carradine did, or is he the only guy?
The autoerotic asphyxiation. As far as I know, he's the only one that like, I'm sure someone else probably did it, but they had people around them decent enough to pull their pants up. You know what I mean?
Oh, 100%. Like, if I walk in on someone who
Elvis
has
died on the shitter
themselves to death, like, I would have to, unless they were an enemy of mine, I'd pull their pants up, I'd take that rope off, and I'd like throw them in the yard or something and be like, he just passed out doing yard work.
Or like, just regular suicide almost would be better than like accidental jerk off suicide.
Yeah,
you
retie the tie.
I would prefer my family think that I had killed myself than that I had accidentally autoerotic asphyxiated myself to death, wouldn't you?
That's a good question. It's more palatable.
That's
actually
a good either or.
This is its own trolley question.
This is our new like mermaid top or bottom question.
Yeah, that's it. Would you rather have a loved one kill themselves accidentally through hanging, trying to get the best nut, or kill themselves out of desperation and depression? Ooh, I don't know. I think I'm going to go the masturbation one. I would prefer the masturbation one, but I fix it so that to the world, that's not their...
Well, see, that's not the question, though. It's you that it's going to happen to. So you are going to autoerotic asphyxiate yourself to death, and I'm going to find you. Do you want me to do that? Because if I clean up the mess, your family now thinks that out of nowhere, you killed yourself.
Damn, I'm going to have to take one for the team and just have it be known that I David Carradine to myself. I think for the sake of my family, my friend, yeah, 100%.
They'd always be like, they blame themselves. Like, how didn't I see it? How didn't I see it? You know, like they'd be like, mate, well, he did say this that one time. He said that to you and you never did anything. Like the whole family's rupturing over a non-issue that you've thrown upon them.
He could only talk about his feelings in Indian guy voice. Why didn't we notice?
Hardest part of your head.
Chuck Norris?
No. Yes.
I know. Do you remember the intro song?
I probably would if you sang it.
So Chuck Norris decided...
I thought you were going to sing it.
Don't worry, I am.
Okay.
It's just important to know that if you go to YouTube and search... Chuck Norris Texas Ranger intro music, it's him singing. He sang it. So it's in the eyes of the ranger are upon you, watching every move you make. When you go to Texas, look around you, because that's where the ranger's gonna be.
Yeah, it's an alternative world where there's fascists in control of everything.
I expected a rhyme at the end of the song and it didn't.
There probably are. I don't know the rest of the lyrics, but it was Chuck Norris and this black guy, and they were like Texas Rangers, and they run around karate kicking any body who said, boo, you talk shit, you got the foot. And we only, yeah. I think the death toll from that is so minuscule, it's shocking. Like I think 9/11 was worse than the Revolutionary War.
There's no way. Yeah.
Can we fact check that, Zach?
3,000. I think 3,000 people died on 9/11, right?
It sounds roughly. Right. I'm gonna call it 3,300 on 9/11. I'm include all the planes and the Pentagon, which didn't happen.
Yeah, you got to include that.
Those were missiles.
Pentagon thing didn't happen, and they I'm guessing Building 7.
There's just no way. There were
well, Zach's gonna Google it up.
I know that the Revolutionary War wasn't like fucking Civil War levels by a long shot, or World War One or some shit, but it's got to be a lot of 9/11s.
How many U.S. casualties in the Revolutionary War? That's the number we're looking for.
Okay. Yeah, because the British weren't real people.
25 to 70. But they were not keeping good track.
But 68. It says 6,800 killed in battle. On the American side, 17,000 from disease.
I'm not counting the disease.
No, you can't. Right,
if you count disease, then we're going to 9/11 all those cancer victims in. All right? John Stewart's not preaching for nothing, folks.
No,
all right,
9/11 times 1,000.
Grandfather in the cancer 9/11, and what does that mean? 9/11
times 27.
The thing about the disease, Kyle, is a lot of those were from gunshots. Right, yeah. You get a wound and you die later.
Oh, that's not true. No,
you know, I just said it. What would I?
You shot me with the flu bullet.
No. It's gangrene,
gonna fester
it
into a nasty
infected.
Cough.
It gets septic, which I think is a thing doctors
that
say.
That ain't what they're talking about. They're talking about the flu and colds and the plague and whatever the fuck, dysentery, some of the old timey diseases, whooping cough, kennel cough.
It's rude to shit on a plane. That's for peeing. Wait till the terminal. Get
Absolutely.
It together.
Nah. Yeah. And emergency. Oh, Jacob doesn't agree. Jacob, tell him.
Hey, man, if you got to go, you got to go. I'll shit anywhere. I've blown up bathrooms at fucking holiday parties. No way.
Yo, dude, you remember that Christmas party?
Yeah.
At Liz's house where you shit?
Dude,
you shit in the only bathroom.
You're a terrorist.
I shit in the only bathroom, okay? And I waited in there to let it air out a little bit and occasionally peeked my head out to see if anybody was waiting and then just left the door wide open. And then 10 minutes later, Liz, the owner of the house, walks by and she goes, wait, what the fuck is that smell? I was right next to the kitchen, too. It was a good time.
Right next to oh, that is bad when you're like at a get-together at an apartment or something.
We were asked to leave.
Like right next to the kitchen.
I'll poop anywhere. I'll shit on the floor right now if I need to.
What?
I believe
there's
you.
There's better options. No, I don't believe him.
He's in like that Superdome scenario. It's been an hour and he's shitting on the floor.
But it wouldn't, and you know, call me high-minded, but it's not that I would be embarrassed to shit on the plane. It's that I'm putting myself in the shoes of like someone else having to go in after me, knowing that they're also trapped. Like if all of us have gone into bathrooms on airplanes and someone clearly shit, and I get like, I kind of angry about it where I'm like, you fucking piece of shit. Like, whereas if you walk into like at a ballpark or a Walmart or a grocery store or whatever, it's like, it smells like shit. Of course it does. People shit here, but it's cause we're all in this together up in the sky. And for someone to just throw all courtesy to the wind.
I shit before I leave my home. Like when I wake up in the morning, it's part of my morning routine as much as like washing my face or brushing my teeth. There's no emergency shits in my life.
For me, pooping, it's not that I won't poop in public, but it's an emergency situation.
Yeah.
Like, if you're shitting at the airport, it's an emergency. Can I tell you what I heard coming out of a stall?
I can imagine.
Yeah, probably shit.
I'm washing my hands, and I just hear this dude behind me go, oh, why is this happening to me?
We've all been there, brother.
I wish you replied that.
You know why, boy.
He's sitting over there. Said. He's like, Lord, I haven't spoken to you in a long time.
Yeah, cheesy bread's good, but like what they charge for is asinine.
Sunshine also is another sci-fi that I really want to watch. That's where they go to like restart the sun or something. It's also having a hard
restart
time getting that on
sun.
I don't remember what
it's
they do exactly.
Out. It's over.
You know, you say that, but But yeah, he's a real giver upper. Have you noticed that? No,
I know. The sun goes out. He's like, forget everything. The
sun goes out. There's no stick-to-itiveness with this guy. Get up there with a fucking zip pole and get it going.
I mean, we'll go below and use the Earth's core to heat our underground subterranean lairs, where we'll subsist on some sort of fungus paste that we grow. And someday, after we guide the Earth to a new star, we'll be able to go up topside again.
Nah, you have fun with that. I'm gonna jack myself off to death. I'm gonna go out like a king. Then you'll come in there and you'll see me dead, hanging with cum, with more cum than you've ever seen in your life, and you'll be like, "Wow, he went out like a champ. He did it." What are you ordering?
That's me. No, that's me taking pictures.
You'd be so embarrassed if the internet still worked.
Yeah. You're lucky there's no more phone service anywhere.
What did you find it, Woody?
I don't know if it's true.
If what's true?
If the it's picture? The real video.
Link me.
On its way.
Woody's gamertag just supplied me with child porn.
You bastard. I don't think that's really her. This girl doesn't look 14. Wings, what do you want thrown into your lineage?
Shoot, you're going Spartan shit. Aryans?
Aryans? Wow. You are Aryan, aren't you?
I don't know what that means.
Would that make you blonde?
I got German heritage, but like Aryans, like they're supposed to be the super race.
All right, now this got way too racist for me. I'm just throwing that out there. I was being fun and like uplifting and lighthearted about it. You know, little Asian math skills. Wings going all fucked up with it. I'm not down there.
I think I would have gone African American for the just if I had just a little more athletic ability. I think I could have done something with that.
Mike's talking about his basketball skills are lackluster.
Definitely. He is. Mike is a basketball player. For those that don't know, Mike is actually a basketball player. He's a guy who enjoys playing basketball. Even now in his 20s, he's like a league player. He does his thing. And he just got all racist with it and said, I want to be black, so I'm better at basketball.
But Mike,
that would have given me just that edge that I needed, man. That would have made the difference between majoring in architecture or playing on the college team.
I think about this, Mike. Saw you against Bash. Like, think of the steps backwards you could have taken.
Yeah, Mike. But here's the problem, Mike. Think about what that's going to do to your credit score.
Oh no! No. All right. New topic. I can't handle this anymore.
Yeah. And I get blamed for the racism here. Come on.
That's funny.
All right. This one's going to go to
society that didn't even
talking about master race, motherfucker. I don't want nothing to do with that.
All right. That was.
Did you ever watch
the
original with?
Oh yeah.
Chuck Norris.
No. Yes.
I know. Do you remember the intro song?
I probably would if you sang it.
So Chuck Norris decided.
I thought you were going to sing it.
Don't worry, I am.
Okay.
It's just important to know that. If you go to YouTube and search Chuck Norris Texas Ranger intro music, it's him singing. He sang it. So it's in the eyes of the ranger are upon you, watching every move you make. When you go to Texas, look around you, because that's where the ranger's going to be.
Yeah, it's an alternative. World where there's fascists in control of everything.
I expected a rhyme at the end of the song and it didn't.
There probably are. I don't know the rest of the lyrics, but it was Chuck Norris and this black guy, and they were like Texas Rangers, and they run around karate kicking anybody who said boo. You talk shit, you got the foot.
That was good. You need some strong men out there making sure there's no the hoodlums and no goodnicks running around causing problems for all the other ranchers.
Oh, just so you know, I have decided to make next Mail Monday not about not about sex at all. So if you guys that don't know, my wife just came in and threw something at me. It'll be on the screen.
We just saw it.
Let me tell you how smart cows are. Our cows
can't
escape.
Wait for this debate. The intelligence of cows. Bring it. In this corner, we got Kyle arguing that cows are intelligent beings and Taylor who says they're dumb.
Dude, I've never been more confident at the beginning of a debate.
Our cows would escape through all sorts of like fences and shit. They would get out. They would go all the way to town. At town, next to the highway, fucking state patrol call. Your cows are up here about to cross highway 57 and get obliterated. Okay. And so I'd go up there.
Do chickens go to the convenience store, buy a Snickers bar, and get home?
I go up there, and I'm talking about this is like 3 miles from home. I got to drive like down the road. So I got to go this big long way around. I get there, and there they are in the field. I get the shotgun out, walk out in the field, and go, hey, get back home. They know the pump of a shotgun because they've been shot in the ass before. They all turn 180 degrees, and they go back home 3 fucking miles. So fast, they beat me there.
Did you discipline the cows by shooting them?
Yeah. Yeah, with birdshot from range, it just stings their ass. They're made of leather.
Now that it's true.
Zach, fact check that. Are cows really made of leather?
Yeah, but yeah. Kyle, if you woke up tomorrow with the intellect of a cow, it would ruin your life.
That's not true. Have you not seen the show?
No fucking shit.
They can't even spell if Chick-fil-A's taught me anything.
Yeah. Actually, the Chick-fil-A teaches you that they're not only kind of intelligent, they're a bit duplicitous.
They're trying to spell other animals down the river.
How'd they get up that ladder?
Yeah,
they didn't get down, I can tell you that.
Robust ladder.
No, I've always found the cows to be really intelligent as far as like knowing, you know, when you catch a dog doing something he's not supposed to do and you can tell he knows he's not supposed to have that.
Yeah.
You like catch him with a shoe or something and he's like, oh, fuck, you caught me. Cows are like that. They have that level of intelligence where like they get caught and they're like, sorry, boss. My bad. We're cool. And you got me.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got me. Yeah. So yeah,
they're not as dumb as chickens. You're right.
No, chickens are like bugs to me. I think of chickens like insects. Like chickens and grasshoppers are on the same level. As
you guys all fell in love with Henrietta.
We just. All right, we're not gonna do that. I don't know why you would want to talk about that story.
I'm the alpha in that situation. The same way that Theon Greyjoy was an alpha.
We went on a survival trip about 8 years ago or so, me, Woody, our friend Chiz, and a cameraman that we hired to come and document the whole nonsense. Spent 5 days in the wilderness. Actually on Mount Currahee, where they filmed Band of Brothers, the first episode, it's up there, and in that wildlife preserve area. And we brought a chicken with us from my dad's poultry farm. I brought a hen and like a 5-pound chicken, a live one. And the idea was at some point we would slaughter the chicken and eat it. However, after a few days, this became the camp mascot. We thought we had to cage it or keep it in a box. We let it out and it just chilled. It stayed with us on purpose. It killed the bugs.
The campsite free of bugs.
It started eating all the bugs that were coming around.
Bearing his weight. Yeah.
People started petting it.
Mm.
And
it was named?
Henrietta.
There we go.
And Woody killed that thing. Eventually, brutally than any Palestinian Hamas member would ever dare. I've seen.
Hey, this is a little fucked up. Like
I've seen cartel videos on Live Leak that begin with an extra warning after the first one. Like seriously. But they were quicker to kill those guys.
Especially if you're a student at Columbia University, please turn it off.
Yeah. You ever see the one where the two guys are tied up and the cartels guy offers them chainsaw or knife to be killed with?
Mm-mm.
No.
Two guys sitting on the ground, they're tied up, hands behind their back, shirts off. They've had their asses whipped. And dude asks them, you know, you want the knife or the chainsaw? And dude goes, chainsaw. And I was like, whoa! He must know something I don't, because that sounds rough. Dude comes at him with the chainsaw, hits, you know, he's the chainsaw man is right-handed, so he's holding it like that. He's coming down from high left to low right, so in the guy's neck, and that's it. His head's off. Like, as fast as I said that, his head's off, and it's like...
Introducing liquid anesthesia.
What does this sign say?
Don't drink anymore. I don't care for it. I don't enjoy being drunk. So I find other ways to have a good time.
I'm big. I'm small. I'm fast.